And if I had been 1 fucking second later out that gate, I would probably be dead.
Good evening, everyone. A group of tradies on Smoko have leapt into action, making a citizen's arrest outside a Broadbeach construction site.
Tonight, we can show you the aftermath of the dramatic takedown of a man for allegedly crashing a stolen car.
Pinned by his high-vis pursuers after a takedown in the middle of a road. A citizen's arrest, tradie style.
No one's putting pressure on you, calm down.
The 25-year-old man is accused of crashing a stolen Ford Mondeo into a power pole on Surf Parade at 10:45 this morning.
Power lines were rocking. I thought the power lines were going to come down, so I just jumped out of the way.
It happened just next to a pedestrian crossing.
If you and the dogs were walking across the road at that time, well, we'd be history.
The driver, who claimed he had fallen asleep at the wheel, wasn't hurt, instead running off.
All the workers grabbed him, evidently. They were chasing him down the street.
How good are our tradies, eh? So just finished some smoko. We're in the right place at the right time and managed to take him in the custody. They're quite lucky too, you know. The car's crashed within about 5 metres of where they were.
The construction workers restrained him until backup in blue arrived.
So he's come down here. We were walking across a pedestrian crossing. And then he's come and swerved off that side of the road. Crashed straight into the pole, missed me and Alex by about a metre. And then I had to chase the cunt down over here. He ran from the car, I chased him down and tackled him over there where that police car is.
Bruh. It's Friday arvo. The footage and stuff that you just seen was from this morning at 10 o'clock. Fuck, it rattled me. Legit, like, we were just walking out of sight, doing absolutely nothing wrong. And if I had been 1 fucking second later out that gate, I would probably be dead. So as you can see in the video, he's just been off his fucking head, this guy. Stolen car, off his head on drugs, had heaps of stolen shit in the car. He's come around, missed me and Alex by literally a meter. Felt the fucking wind of the car behind my back before it ran into the fucking pole, man. I get everything a little bit shaky thinking about it. Fucking hell, bro. It's so close. You never understand. You can never really truly put into words how easy it can be for something fucked up like that to happen. And then I could have either been in a wheelchair or dead or fucked up, or Alex and his son. As soon as I finished, we got out of the situation, all the cops and all the fucking news reporters and everything left and whatever, I couldn't stop thinking about my life and what I've done and what I need to do, and how much more I have to do before I'm, you know, ready to say, alright, that's enough. Really makes me contemplate whether I'm doing the right thing, whether I'm in this job for the right reasons, whether I'm living in line with myself and what I really want to do, or if I'm, you know, chasing something for the wrong reasons. Oh, man. I am going to take the weekend to think about it and reassess what I want to do, because that scared the fuck out of me. Alright, it is Monday. That shit that you just seen happened on Friday. Sorry, I got no shirt on. I've come home, I'm trying to get this instantly to really capture it, capture the emotion, capture the feeling. So like I said, on Friday, I'm really going to take the weekend to think about me and my life and my job and what I'm doing and if it's where I'm supposed to be right now. And I think you can probably tell by my energy right now that fuck that shit. I'm done. I quit today. The job is fucking finished. Handed in my resignation and I'm out, bro. I am, by the title of the video, you can see it's time to start living my fucking life and go and do the shit that I've always said I wanted to do, but have been too fucking caught up in the bullshit to do it. So, I don't know what I've got going on yet. I don't know where I'm going. I don't know what I'm doing. I've got a few little things in the works, but all I know is that I'm packing my shit up. I've already started selling my shit. In the background here, you can't see it obviously, but I've already started selling my shit. I'm gonna deck my ute out and I'm gonna fuck off. I don't know where, I don't know for how long, I don't know what I'm gonna be doing, but I'm gonna go with the wind, go with my gut, just telling me, leave, figure it out, go and fucking live. The feeling I feel right now is pretty overwhelming. I'm fucking pumped and I'm happy and I'm so fucking excited. The thought of not knowing what I'm doing yet scares me a little bit, but at the same time I'm like, let's go, cunt. Nothing bad can happen from this, I don't think, in terms of like fucking just whatever, just go with the flow, baby. That's all I had to say. I wanted to get it out. While I'm thinking about it, I'm gonna take the weekend to try and figure some of my shit out, sell as much of my shit as I possibly can. And then next week, we're gonna be into it, setting up, getting shit done, trying to find a job somewhere, trying to find something to go and do somewhere. And just, yeah, get ready to pack up and fuck off. I'll see you guys on Monday. Actually, not on Monday. I'll see you guys later in the week. It is Monday. I'm all over the place. It's go time, baby. Let's get it. Oh, God. Back doing it again. We're packing up. And we're moving, son. Sorry, this lens is very close to my face because I've got the wrong lens on. It's Friday. I've knocked off work early. I'm just filming this because I'm in a fucking rush. But you can see shit's going ahead. I'm packing my shit up, trying to get a jump on it. I've figured something out, but right now I'm running late. I've got to go pick up something for the ute to set the ute up. So I'm going to run and then I'm going to talk to you in the car about what the fuck I have worked out. Let's go. Alright, motherfuckers. So, I have sorted my life out a little bit. I am now in 2 weeks moving from the Goldie, going to the snow. I got a job on a lift just fucking around, putting people on lifts, snowboard on my brakes, a couple of days off a week to snowboard, and that is me for the next 3 months. I'm fucking pumped. I haven't been to the snow for a minute, a couple years actually, but I fucking love it. It's probably my favorite things in the world to do. So I'm absolutely stoked that I've got a job there doing that. Not worried about it as a job. I'm just, you know, it's a place to live and a place to go there and be there and have some fucking fun, bro. So I am stoked for that. I appreciate the people that helped me with that. Bailey, you probably won't watch this. Goons, appreciate you. And bruh, I'm fucking pumped. So right now I'm on my way to Toowoomba. The back of the ute's clean, all the shit's off it. I'm putting a canopy straight on the back so I can set that up and live out of it if I need to after the snow. And get it Mickey Mouse and Primo for whatever I'm doing. Going forward, man, I've got some shit that I want to get done. I want to go and do shit. I want to live my life. I want to fucking adventure. So I'm setting the rig up so that it is adventure friendly.
I have a couple hours to go in this drive. So let's roll some B-roll and then I will see you once the big grey girl has her new canopy installed. A little bit, roll it up, take a hit, feeling lit, feeling right, 2 a.m. summer night. I don't care, hand on the wheel, driving drunk, I'm doing my thing, rolling the mid beside him now, living my life. Alright, so it is now Wednesday the following week. I'm pretty sure it was Friday when I started the last part of this video where I said I'm gonna go deck the ute out. So I've done pretty well over the last couple days. I'm gonna give you a little look at the progress of the rig. Yeah, and keep you updated as this sort of continues to advance in terms of what this looks like. But as of right now, this is how we're looking. So I went and put some new wheels, some new tires on there. These other ones were just shitty highway tires. They're looking pretty dope. And I've got this big bad boy canopy on here. And the rooftop tent. So the plan is to have this set up with a fridge, barbecue, drawers, all that sort of shit. And then rooftop tent on top. So that after I'm at the snow for a couple months, wherever the fuck I want to go to, I can just pack up and go and live out of this, work out of this, do whatever the fuck I want to do. And I still don't have a plan as to what the fuck I'm doing going forward, but like I said before, I am going to the snow. I have, what day is it today? Today's Thursday, fucking Wednesday. I don't even know what day of the week it is at the moment because my life has just been scatterbrained as fuck, trying to get everything sorted so quickly. We're just riding the wave. Back to it. Sorry, I'm going all over the place. Fuck me. I have until next Friday, so I've got a week and the weekend until I'm leaving. So the next 10 days or so is just me sorting the rest of my shit out, selling as much of my stuff as I possibly can so I don't have to take it with me. And then just really just enjoying the rest of the time I have at work with my boys that are at work. Because I'm gonna miss those cunts. You know, it's weird that sometimes the people that you work with become your best friends, and you know, these guys are a bit older than me, but they're fucking legends, and I love them, and I'm gonna miss them. I'm gonna miss working there, and it's a fucking good job, but I know this is what I need to do. So yeah, I know none of those boys will ever watch this because they're not that kind of guy. They don't know this side of me. I've never talked about this stuff to them, but I fucking love you cunts. Yous have had a massive impact on my life. Albie, especially you, my best mate. I fucking love you to death and appreciate everything that you've done for me. So that's it for the little heartfelt part of it. And that's it for the update on the rig. I'm going to catch up with you in a couple days just to see how everything's progressing and also show you the big trip to the snow. I will see you then. Alrighty, motherfuckers. It is Thursday. Tomorrow is my last day of work. And then I'm going out with the boys tomorrow night just as a little, you know, farewell, send off, whatever you want to call it. So the time's finally come. I'm fucking packing up and I'm going to the snow. So I have got everything sorted and packed. Crazy, bro, that's my whole life right there in three bags, plus my snowboard and snow gear. The rest of the shit is already all packed up in the ute. Oh, bro, it's a bit of a bittersweet thing for me right now, this actually, and I didn't think it was going to be. I thought that I would have been sweet and pumped and happy to be going, which I am, but I don't know, this house and the last, you know, 9-10 months have been a fucking roller coaster, and I've learnt more in the last 9 months about myself, about life, about people than I have for the rest of my life combined. And I've grown more in the last 9 months than, you know, I ever have in my life. So I don't know. This place, this little apartment,
It's always going to be memorable for me and something that I'll look back at. And, you know, whilst there's been, like, again, fucking ups and downs and highs and lows and everything else in between, it's a special place for me because of what, you know, has happened while I've been here. With that being said, Kyle, I know you'll watch this because you're an OG and you appreciate and see the work that I put in, and I know you support that. Thank you, mate. Thank you for having me here. Thank you for being the mate that you are. There's very few people in my life or in the world that I trust as much as I trust you. So I fucking love you. I appreciate you having me here. And, you know, I wish you nothing but the best, mate. You're my brother and I love you forever. But that's enough of the sloppy shit. I know he's gonna laugh at that. Right now, it's time to pack the rig up and get ready to hit the road first thing Saturday morning. Let's do it.
Jordan 4s or Jordan 1s, Rolexes got more than one. My AP costs 31, millimeters 41. Stick, him up with a stick, stick, need you the shorter one. You can't short me one, in a club with the shortest one. Lighty, the shortest one, on my mind, Georgia one. Crocodile bag, I bought a one, vegan ting, I slaughter one. Freaks, I got more than one, fuck daddy and daughter one. Tory putting in labour, this that Jeremy Corbyn one. Awkward one, raise me there, wait. Tortoise one, I need a ting, 30 plus, Blackberry and Walkman ones. Look, I left my phone on my babies, silent mode. My guys in riding mode, zombies, survival mode. He's got a new vest, man, pop that showed no microphone.
Oh my god. It's Saturday morning, about 7 o'clock, and I was supposed to leave 3 hours ago. Oh shit. Last night's send-off was about 3 times what I wanted it to be. So I am in an absolute fucking state. But if you want to party with the big boys, you got to back it up like a big boy. So it's time to hit the road. I've got 16 hours of fucking driving ahead of me. And I could not think of anything fucking worse right now. But, gotta do what we gotta do. So let's get this show on the road.
Just like, I've been smooth for so long, I'm trying to get rough. Fuck buffing my nails, dog, I'm trying to get buff. Fuck shaping my beard up, I'm liking the scruff. And fuck the hills, cause I'm living my life in the cut. Can't imagine that I'm gonna meet my wife in the club. We gon' see though, I feel like she more of a CEO. Or maybe she doing volunteer work in Rio. It's not like I need her, but I would love to meet her. Another day, another dollar, another phone with another feature. I don't play goalie, but I'm my brother's keeper. Surrounded by family, I'm not with other people. They say I got my pop's demeanor and mother's features. The garden's still private as ever, the gang driving together. Your boy's striving to be the most dominant ever. The hardest white boy since the one who rapped about vomiting sweaters and holding comments. Cause I promise you I'm honestly better than whoever came to your head right then. They ain't cut from the same thread like him. They don't study doing work.